didn't really expect that I'd be able to afford to have a brand new house built. And I said, hey, this is my budget, what do you reckon? And they said, yep, we can build your house for that. I just never imagined that I could have a house that was brand new for a start. This house is just so me, I love it.
We had to stick to a pretty tight budget, but we ended up choosing a plan that we thought was amazing.
They had great suggestions and a wide range of options.
And better than what we thought we'd get for our budget.
A new home from GJ's is more affordable than you may think.
Hi, I'm Dean Wilson and we're at Ruakaka Beach for the second round of the GJ Gardner Homes New Zealand Beach Volleyball Tour. This is the Northland Slam and we're about to see some semi-final action in the men's and the women's sections.
Welcome to the second leg of the GJ Gardner New Zealand Beach Tour, live from Ruakaka Beach. This is our New Zealand Championships presented by 2L. Previously, we were in Nelson, and we're headed to Christchurch next on February 19th through the 21st, where we're actually going to build the first beach volleyball court ever in Cathedral Square. My name is Ivy Schmidt, and this is our second women's semifinal. Today, we have a couple of absolute legends on the sand. First out, known commonly as Fitzy. Annalise Fitzy is not part of the beach national team, but she is part of the New Zealand indoor national team. Partnered up with Shauna Polly. Shauna Polly is a silver fern. She is part of that national beach squad. What we see today is a lot of mixing up from the partnerships. Out next, we have Francesca Kerwin from Auckland. Partnered up with Alice Lehman from Christchurch. She was formerly an FSU beach volleyball athlete. This foursome is in the mix. They're all mixing up partners this week. So the last semifinal we just had also mixing up partners. Eventually we will find the iconic New Zealand duo that will represent New Zealand in a push for an Olympic qualification. But for today's semifinal pairing, Francesca Kerwin out of Auckland, Alice Lehman out of Nelson, Annalise Fitzy is out of... Sorry, I don't actually know where she is from, but Shauna Polly's from Hamilton. And Alice Lehman with an incredible block to start the game off. So Francesca Kerwin actually partnered the entire last tour with Olivia McDonald. And on the other side, Shauna Polly partnered the tour with Julia Tilley. And that duo was just won the last semifinal matchup, so they're on to the finals. So we could see a potential ex-partner final match. Or we are guaranteed an ex-partner final match. Big swing from Shauna, but easy dig. And down the line. As I've been saying all day, that dig to kill conversion, hard to do, but when it's done, it looks effortless. That is beach volleyball for you. Zeman just long. So Zeman is actually just back from playing in the States for the last few years. I believe she's at Minnesota playing indoors and then transferred over to FSU for beach volleyball. But going head-to-head against Fitzy. Fitzy with an incredible block. One of the skills I've never mastered is how to actually properly line up, press your hands over, and... you know, stop the ball from crossing over the side of the net. love to see other players do it. Can admire it even more because I'm unable to do it. And Fitzy will serve again.
It just seems like they are.
We have a foot fault from Fitzy. That jump serve, she must have got her toes caught up in the line. It's a double sword. You want to get as close to that line as possible, jump over it and into the court, make that contact as close to the net as possible so that she can get more power on the ball and run up and block. But you can't cross the line. Another service error. And another service error. I believe Shauna Polly was actually voted best server on the tour last year. I think she won quite a few of the awards last year. An absolute stud of a human being. Partnered with Fitzy for this event. Fitzy's pretty big in the indoor New Zealand world, making her debut on the beach. Doing an incredible job on the beach as well. That wind is really coming into play here. Everyone's just trying to cope, trying to get that ball up and over, but not quite making that effort in. I once had a friend say they would be amazing at volleyball if there was no net and no lines, if they could just do whatever they wanted. It's like, yeah, it would be quite a different game if there were no lines. If you could just hit the ball, no net, no lines, yeah, we would all be really good at it. And another service error. Again, so that wind is at her back. She's jump serving. Needs to take a little off to keep that ball in play. It's a point for point game, but so far it's been a game of errors. I think we've seen a few earned points, but it's been mostly errors. Passing errors, serving errors, and hitting errors. We'll have a side switch at 8-6, change the good sides. Let's see if, as Polly and Fitzy cross over to the good side, if they'll be able to convert a few more points and use that good side to their advantage. Typically, when teams cross the net, they will try and make a goal of how many points they will earn on the good side or how many points they will earn on the bad side. You typically want to earn, if there's 7 points, one of them, at least 4 on the good side. And on the bad side, sometimes you're just trying to survive. Let's just get one up, one out. I don't think the wind is quite that bad that only one should be your goal today, but I think a 3-4 split is a good ratio for today.
Don't do it.
Polly is back to serve, sticking with that jump serve. Don't. And that will be a service ace. A service ace with that net coming into play. Use the equipment, helps out a lot. My old school players, you're probably like, what? That back in my day, that wouldn't be legal. It is today. Oh, love to see that poke. Dig to kill. Very physical player, incredible shape. Digs the ball, gets up to the net, and gets up and puts the ball away. Again, using the equipment.
Hands on three.
And there we see the aggression of her jump serve. I think she was playing it a little safe after her first service error. But there you really saw her put her full effort into that one. Alice Zeman back to serve. A lot of our blockers that run up to the net will use a jump serve just because the momentum will carry them forward. It's a lot easier to jump and then run into the court. But also with that, sometimes a little bit harder to control. You might see a few more errors from them, especially our younger players. Especially today with this wind, this kind of a buzz up the beach, a little bit more high pressure. that power from Shauna Pauley. Another player who was not sitting on the couch eating Tim Tams during lockdown. Jump serve, jump float, and a little bit long. She's a very, very powerful swing. With that wind blowing in her face, should be able to sneak that one in, but just long. Indoor court's a little bit longer than a beach court, so not sure if that has something to do with it. Maybe some pregame nerves, but again, score is 11-10 here for a tactical timeout, so it's been pretty much point for point. We're seeing a few more points earned. Still a game of errors. I'd love to see if we can keep that first serve in, give it a little bit more of a game, give a little bit more warm-up going into the finals. You can see those flags flying, 25-kilometer winds. 5 kilometers per hour winds, but still should be able to keep that first ball in. Just give them something to think about, even if it's not an ace. Put the ball over the net, make them think, make them move their feet, make them try and play volleyball. And the option, loves an option. Always have to be hit. That nice little short knuckle down. Get the ball to the sand. Slip, slap, slop. And another service error. We want to keep it point for point. Zaman back to serve. Keeping it in. Making her pass. Making her move her feet to the ball. Pauley able to get that kill. And Fitzy's back to serve. I'd love to see maybe a switch up on her approach. Change something up. It is out. Sometimes in life we want to keep doing the same thing and hope for different results. I'd love to see her maybe move to a standing flow or maybe stand on the other side of the court, go from, instead of a line-to-line serve, maybe go angle-angle, give herself a little bit more room. A nice option there, but Shauna Pauley is just so athletic. Two digs. Tried for the third. Not able to get her hand there. Alice Amon over on one. Getting it done. Moving on to the next point. Francesca Kerwin back to serve. She loves a jump float, but she just does a standing jump float. Another service error. We do say in beach volleyball that they are contagious. It does seem that if one team is going to serve out, the other team also will serve out. We like to keep it even. Like to keep it fair. If only one team was doing it, wouldn't be much of a volleyball game, would it? Nice save by Shauna Pauley. And there is that power, there is that athleticism. A couple digs, great set, push the ball away. And we will switch sides of court, 15-13. Pauley Fitzy moving to the good side. Interestingly enough, though, I don't think either team has really done much better or much worse from either side. I think it's literally been the team that can serve in today, I think is going to win this game. Like I said, today is a game of errors. If we can control the ball, if we can get that first ball in, give us a little bit more of a ball game to watch. option, but Polly's over that one. I think if it hadn't grabbed the net, Zimmerman was aiming for that deeper corner. I see it again. Oh. Good effort, good effort. Great idea. Wasn't quite able to execute there. Polly and Fitzy able to just scrap the balls over the net and wait for the other team to make the error. Sometimes that's all it is just a waiting game. If you can do the work and let the other team make the errors, doesn't have to be too perfect, doesn't have to be pretty. Just to let someone else have the ball. Point for point, ladies, point for point. Kerwin back to serve. It is a contagion. The miss serves. Polly going with the standing float. She's decided that she will not be part of this. She's just going to get the ball over and she will get it in. And look at that. Converts it to a point. They increase their lead to 3. I think that is the biggest lead we've had so far. Everything else has been point for point. And they will take a timeout. Great time to do that. Kerwin Zeman are down by 3. I'm not ruling them out at all. It's a close game with this win, with the amount of errors that everyone's been making. Honestly, just getting the ball over and in right now is the biggest struggle. The wind's picking up a little bit, so we'll make it even more of a struggle to get that going. But as you can see, what a gorgeous, gorgeous day. It's 25 degrees. That water, I believe, is 22 degrees. It feels like you're walking in just like a warm spa. It's beautiful. It's so nice. Yesterday we had dolphins. Came right up to the coast. Some of us swam out to say hello. A few of the girls stopped play to go take a video. Should be making a migration shortly. And the girls are back on the court to play. I'm excited to see what changes Kerwin and Zeman will make coming out. Polly is back to serve. She's been the strongest server in this game. Jump float in. Zeman with another option, this time for the kill. A nice cutback, thumb up, slide approach. Wonder if she played middle ever. A big aggressive serve from Zeman coming up. I think this one is for the gold. A great spot, great effort there. And what a roll up from Polly. Great set for Zeman. Converting that one to a point. Magical things happen when we serve in. And what a serve too. Caught her on the outside left arm into that deep corner with the wind, making her partner have to roll it all the way up and giving Alice actually the set instead of Fitzy. Back to serve again for Zeman. Another serve in. Shauna Polly with the option. Shauna Polly with the kill. Just sneaking that one by the defense because we had the angle block from Alice Lehman taking that right court and Francesca Kerwin on the left side defending, but caught that dribble of a net, dropped right in front of Kerwin. Kerwin Zeman hanging in there, point for point, 18-19. Behind by one, but serving into the wind. Good side here. Oh, thought that was going to be a tape dribbler, but that wind just brought it back to their side. And Shauna Polly back to serve. Jump float to Kerwin. An option. What a beautiful option. It's like the wind stopped blowing. The volleyball gods said, please have this point. I love the intense concentration from all these players right now. We haven't had a missed serve. And almost 2 points. And a point for Kerwin. Kerwin and Simon tried to combine their names up together to make a superhero team. We have a ball game, ladies and gents. 20 all. Have to win by two in beach volleyball. Have to win by two. I do not believe there's a cap for this game. So if we keep it point for point, could be a tiring semifinal match for whoever has to meet up with Tilly McDonald. Simon's back serve. Serving at Shauna Pauly. Pauly's up at the net, leaving Fitzy to defend that backcourt. I don't think that's quite their strength. I'd like to see Fitzy take control, go up to the net on that one, and leave Pauly to patrol that backcourt. Great high pressure serving right here. Struggled serving in all day, and now we are on a run of probably the most high pressure serves. Game point. And to finish it out 22-20. What a great game. What a great game. You could really see the shift in focus there. It went from the service error game of, okay, they miss it, I'm gonna miss it, they miss it, I'm gonna miss it, to, okay, let's just get the ball in, to all of a sudden you see the serves moving around, cutting seams, dropping short, going deep. I think that next game, we're gonna see a lot less service errors and a lot more volleyball. So the Northland Slam is also the New Zealand Championships, and we are presented by 2L today. The GJ Gardner New Zealand Beach Tour has 5 stops.
Social distancing.
Five stops this tour. We've done one in Nelson. And this one is in Ruakaka. Next, we're going to be in Christchurch, and then we're going to have a doubleheader mount back to back, Mount Maunganui. I have to say, Ruakaka is my favorite beach in New Zealand, but Mount Maunganui gives it a run for its money. That is my home beach. That's a lot of these girls' home beach. Right now, actually, most of the girls on the court are from Auckland. They train in Auckland. Shauna Pauly is the lone wolf from Hamilton. But I believe she does most of her training in Maunganui, Mount Maunganui. And these events are only getting bigger and better every time I see them. Shauna Pauly back to serve. Oh, there is that indoor power from Fitzy. And the wind is so powerful, we actually lost the monitor. It was blown off the table and into the sand. I think we're all sorted up now. The net is bouncing, the lines are wiggling, the flags are about to fly free. Hold on to your umbrellas, ladies. Hold on to your hats. Tape them down. Oh, those hands, that beautiful back set. Haven't seen too many of those from the girls' players today. Love to see it now. Beautiful back hand set to Shauna Pauly out of the middle, rips that ball wide. Fitzy back to serve. still doing a jump, but turning it into a topspin instead of a float. Able to sneak that one in. Kerwin with a great dig, and then Zyman just puts it away. Nice up by Polly, but just not able to make much out of that. That will be a point for Kerwin Zyman. Zyman back to serve. She had a great run last game. They were down and ended up winning 22-20. When everyone else was serving out, she stepped up and started just keeping it high pressure serves. And Polly powering that through Zyman's block. Polly sticking to a jump float this game. Putting the pressure on Kerwin. Great pass set. I think she was just a little early on that swing. Might have been expecting a little bit lower of a set. That's one of the struggles of switching up partners. You get used to playing with the same person, get used to their setting. Throw in a different player, different sets. You have some positives and negatives in that. I think it makes it a lot more fun, a lot more competitive to see the girls switch it up, though. Oh, beautiful turn, beautiful turn. Got the touch on the block, dropped turn, dug it up nice and high. Her partner could have easily done something with that, put it over, but Polly was in the net. So we're going to give that point straight to Kerwin Zyman. Kerwin is back to serve. And Kerwin is another entrepreneur, so I know we were talking about one of the boys with his juice company. Kerwin actually imports wine from Italy. You can find it all over New Zealand every time I see the bottles. I think it's called JK14. Every time I see it, I have to buy a bottle. It's amazing. Love to support the players. Oh, beautiful one-arm dig by Zyman. And that roll-up of a set from Kerwin. Yeah, great call by the ref. It was out. It looked like Kerwin touched it, but it was actually out of the bounce of the sand. Kerwin chased it. Ball hits the sand, bounces into her face. Back to serve. Wind at her back. Nice jump float, and then gonna run up to that net. Putting the pressure on Fitzy. Ooh. Ends up putting the pressure on Polly instead. Polly with a wild set there. I think what happened was the wind actually just completely stopped blowing for 10 seconds and just caught a little unawares. Nice high line, crisp, clean shot. I think that is a big difference for these girls coming back from overseas, from their university programs. Zyman was probably training 20, 30 hour weeks for FSU with, all right, you're only going to be hitting high line this entire practice. You have 4 hours of just hitting high line. You better tag that line. Making beach volleyball machines out of us all. A great serve from Shauna Polly. Service ace, and they will switch sides of the court. For a score update, we've got 7-7. Thank you. play by Kerwin. Walking back after that amazing play to go serve. Hopefully she's able to use that momentum in her serve. And she is. Fitzy only able to get one arm and a free ball over the net. Brisbane's able to pick up and put away that ball. And there we go, we've got the score update on TV. Thanks for bearing with us, guys. Just out. I believe that's actually our first service error of the game. That is fantastic. A lot more volleyball this time around, which will make them a little bit more tired moving forward to the finals against Tilly McDonald. Oh, Fitzy, that big, powerful serve, just long. Like I said, it is a contagious disease in the world of volleyball. It makes things fair though. If you had one team always serving out, wouldn't be much of a game. You can just hear the sound when she hits the ball, how powerful she is. It's that heavy indoor arm swing. Kerwin back to serve. Oh, just short. Wind in her face has to be a little bit more powerful. I think she was trying to drop it short and it was just a little too short. And as a score update, we're actually at 11-10, so we are going to take a technical timeout. The score is 11-10 with, I want to say, Kerwin in the lead. As I was saying before, this is only the second leg of the GJ Gardner New Zealand Beach Tour. We have 5 events this season. We'll not be doing an international tour finals like we did last year because there are no international players in New Zealand right now. Everyone here is partnered with a Kiwi. They're partnered with the Kiwi or they are a resident of New Zealand.
That is so cool.
The borders are closed. Quarantine is in effect. Coronavirus has changed the world of sports this year. Hey, another service error. We're all tied up at 11 all, folks. Oh, that power. She was head and shoulders over that net. Came in strong and aggressive and just found that deep corner. I think she will be an unstoppable player in a few years. Just needs a little bit more wind practice. I think, honestly, in a couple weeks she's going to be unstoppable. Just needs more wind practice. A nice, deep, high-pressure serve from Kerwin, making Fitzy move, making her question, is this ball in or out? Kerwin will serve again. Another deep float, this time just out to the right side of the court. Wanting to sneak in, but not quite there. Oh, beautiful serve from Fitzy. Finally finding that back line, splitting the players, making them just... I don't even think they thought about who should take it because they clearly did not make a move for it. Yeah. seeing that indoor power from Simon as well. She played indoor for a few seasons as well as beach. A little too powerful, a little too far off the net. Didn't quite execute there. They're going to switch sides. Simon and Kerwin finding the good side. Polly and Fitzy moving to the bad side. Wind at their backs.
Did you figure out whether it was on accident or not?
Just out. Sometimes serving is just completely mental. It's kind of like basketball. Any player can make that free throw, but put it game time, making that free throw. Even the best in the NBA are missing their free throws. Same thing with serving. You can stand 20 feet off the court, 20 meters off the court, still make a serve in, put it in a game time. All you have to do is find that ball into the court. You just can't. That's all mental. It doesn't help that there's a lot of wind here. Nice joust at the net. Polly finding the winner. Polly is back to serve. With an ace serve. Great serve by Shauna Polly. And Kerwin Simon will take a timeout there as Polly Fitzy increased their lead to 2. So Kerwin Simon won the first one, sneaking in a win of 22-20. Right now Polly Fitzy are up by 2. Beach volleyball, you just have to win by 2, but the game is typically only to 21. So it's anyone's game at this point. Especially since Simon and Kerwin are on the good side. They just need one side out. Which I think taking a timeout right now is pretty important, because with our serving errors, it just puts a lot more pressure on the service. I think Polly's a pretty mentally strong player, so I'm sure she'll be able to cope. Can't wait to see what happens when we get back on the court. She's ready to go. She's on the court before the referee has even indicated to take the beach. If you guys are in the area, you should come on down. We've got DJ Strobe on the mix, and he's doing a fantastic job of pumping up the crowd. There are prizes. If you can't make this one, please come down to Christchurch or to the Mount Maunganui events. And point from Kerwin Simon. Great use of a timeout. Easy pass that hit on the good side for a point. And Kerwin is actually back to serve. Tight joust at the net. Fitzy's going, actually went the way of Simon. Must have been a net violation there. You want to be aggressive and you want to win the joust, but not at the cost of hitting the net. You hit the net, it is an automatic net violation. It goes the way of the other team.
I'm on 14 minutes left on the set.
Polly with a beautiful rainbow over the block, but Kerwin was able to get a hand on it. Simon was able to chase it down. And then just the wind doing what the wind does best. See right there, that wind just took the ball just out of reach, just out of play. Side switch, 17-18, and a service error by Fitzy, keeping Kerwin and Zayman in the close game, 18 all. Simon is back to serve. She's done a great job in the last game and a half of serving in. I think now we just need to work on serving a little bit further away from each other.
Okay.
Justin splitting that court straight down the middle and tagging the back of the line. Shauna Polly's back to serve. She'll do a jump float. Everyone's pretty timid with their serves right now, I think just because we had so many serving errors last game, but it's become kind of a, here's the ball, easy pass, easy set, free point. So we've got Kerwin back to serve. I'd love to see her move it around, make them think a little bit. Serving in, of course, but away from each other. Splitting the court down the middle. Easy kill from Fitzy. No one at the net, no one playing on the left side of the court. Free court. And Kerwin's aim in are still alive. Service error on game point. Keeping them in the game. 20 all, must win by two. They're on the bad side right now, but they can survive 2 points. They get to go on the good side. Beautiful option. The options have been working so well for everyone today. And Shauna Polly will serve for game point on the good side. Typically, you have the advantage when you are receiving because it's so easy to pass that hill. Just like that. Easy. 21 all, and they will switch sides. Zyme and Kerwin are on the good side again for game point. They will actually have to earn a point here to get game point. So the advantage is still with Polly Fitzy. Oh, beautiful serve, but just long. I thought that was going to drop in with that wind. Service error. And Fitzy will go back to serve. She is going to stay and float. And she has served it in. And there was a touch on that ball. The ref did not see it, but the other team put their hand up and said, I touched that. And that is game. That is game. We have a 23-21 finish by Fitzy and Polly. We are keeping this game as close as possible. As we move into the third set, a game to 15. There's not room for errors in a game to 15. If you want to win, you have to win the first point and all of the next ones. We'll switch at 5, so you have to take advantage of the good side. Minus the wind, it is a gorgeous day at Ruakaka Beach. We have the beautiful mountains in the background. Water is nice and warm. It's 21 degrees. I think outdoors is 25 degrees. Not much of a difference between air and water. Great for a swim. Watch volleyball from the ocean. What more can you ask for? Nice John Deere tractor trailer that actually brought up the live stream caravan, the shed that we were using. It actually could not get all the way up the soft sand. The John Deere tractor trailer could not pull the shed up the soft sand, but these athletes are having to jump in. So they had to switch up their plan just a little bit. And that shows you just how hard beach volleyball is. If a John Deere tractor trailer can't do it, but these girls can, what's the real machine?
Oh, she's got it. It was a sandy bag. Oh, did I? I didn't mean to.
Oh, a a beautiful set from Fitzy to Simon. Simon taking control, putting that ball away, saying thank you very much. Beautiful pass from Polly running behind. Just long. Honestly, it is so windy right now. The coffee cup's flying over, monitor's trying to leave, hydrofast falling, phone flying. But the service was in. The set was saved from the net, but just long on that approach. She's still kind of hitting with an indoor swing, aiming more for that deep back corner instead of getting on top of it and snapping down. It's definitely a hard switch up, and indoor season I think just finished up, so it'll take her a few weeks to adjust that arm swing, but then I think she's gonna be unstoppable. We've seen it a few times. When she finds that back corner, that full extension, that snap down, it's a beautiful thing to watch. She has switched to a standing float. And we will switch sides. Score is now 1-4. Kerwin Zeiman are taking the lead. They really use that good side. Moving to the bad side now with Zeiman serving. She's sticking with her jump float. It's been super effective. Has had very few surface errors since that first game. Oh, Fitzy with a beautiful approach, jump, swing, but just long. I love watching her hit. She's literally getting her head and shoulders above the net. She had a free net there. I think just getting a little too excited, maybe a little frustrated. Not able to find that court. Polly with a left switch back. Polly getting caught at the net, leaving Fitzy to have to defend, and Kerwin just nice and easy swing down the angle of the court.
Yeah, tried him last time.
Putting some power on it, giving some heat, Fitzy unable to control it.
Oh, I won't show the message.
Great pass, great set, and there, oh, just long. And Kerwin Zeiman are taking a strong lead in this third set, 7-1. We're only playing to 15. I think right now they're just gonna put the pressure on Fitzy and let her decide what she wants to do with the ball. She's passing well. Polly's giving her great sets. She's gonna try a poke here. Oh, Polly with an incredible one-handed save. Must have gotten a touch on that, put that back over. Again, Polly with an incredible dig. And then Fitzy lining up that beautiful set. Polly putting the ball down. Great dig by Kerwin. Dig to kill conversion. Haven't seen too many rainbows today, so it's nice to see a little mix-up from Kerwin. Rainbow is deep angle over the head. We see a lot of high lines over the block. Rainbows are a little bit trickier because if you don't put it high enough over the head, you're just right to the defender, nice and easy. Shauna Polly is back to serve. Jump float, nice and deep to Kerwin. Nice lineup on that defense. Fitzy calling an angle block. Polly executing on the defense, but just not able to convert to a point. Kerwin is back to serve, taking a decisive early start to this game, 9-2. Oh, what a play. Polly tried to block that option, got a hand on it, put it into the net, and then tried to cover herself, but again, just not able to convert to a point yet right now. Kerwin will serve again. Yes. So in beach volleyball, we are not allowed to touch the net. That's why we saw the players pause. She just caught the net, and then they decided not worth playing it out until the ref sees it. Sometimes I like to try and sneak a few through, see if anyone notices. Shouldn't do it. Way better to be honest. Great policy, guys. Another net violation there. Great serve by Fitzy. Nice, strong, deep float. Put the pressure on them. They had to actually free ball the ball back. And just like that, Fitzy and Shauna probably are getting that point. And Fitzy's back to serve again. We're going to switch sides. Score is 11-4 now. 4-11. Hopefully the wind dies down a little. See it there, just a few flaps. Give it a minute, it'll be back full force. Great serve by Fitzy. She's really finding her groove right now. Splitting that duo straight down the middle. Again, when you have a new partnership, things like middle serves, middle hits, maybe your old partner used to take it, maybe it was whatever, like, depends on the wind, depends on the side. When you have a new partnership, sometimes you're just not quite comfortable enough to know who's going to take it, especially if you're not normally the one that's taking the middle ball. Another ace service by Fitzy. She's going to move to a jump. And just long. She had a great run, brought them back into the game, but Kerwin Zeiman are moving up 12-6. Pulling within three of a finish and on to the finals. Fitzy, seeing Zeiman drop off the net, does a nice short line drop. Just nice and easy. Didn't go high line, wasn't a hit, just sharp and fast, slapping it down. Zeiman not quite able to control it. And then keeping the pressure on her. Kerwin's done a really great job of passing forward. So it's nice to see them switch off of her. We might have stayed on her a little bit too long. She was siding out very, very well. But now she's actually on the weaker corner, so it'll be interesting to see whether they switch back to her or stay on Zeiman, who's made a few errors. Gonna switch back to Kerwin. Able to side out there, but scrap from Zeiman, or from Polly Fitzy. Zeiman and Kerwin will take that point though. With a thank you very much. Great serve by Kerwin, putting deep hard pressure onto Fitzy. And we have game point on Ruakaka Beach. Game point of the second women's semifinal. We already know that Tilly McDonald are through to the finals. It looks like we're going to have Kerwin Zeiman on to the finals as well, matching them up.
Okay. Yeah, I thought you were too.
And there we have it, folks. Kerwin Zeiman have won the second women's semifinal match, which means that Kerwin will be facing her ex-partner, Olivia McDonald, in the finals. A little volleyball drama for you all. Thank you all for watching so much. Stick around, they're gonna do some live player interviews in just a moment from this lovely beach in Northland, Ruakaka. Cheers, you guys. My name is Ivy Schmidt. Thank you for listening, and we'll see you again for the men's final right here at 3 o'clock. Stick around.
Oh, okay.
Well, we've just had the second of our semi-finals, an epic three-set battle. It's been taken out by Francesca Kerwin and Alice Zaman. And Alice, you first, an absolutely brilliant three-setter there.
Thank you. I thought we battled really hard, and so did they. And, like, we have a really good culture between all of us, so we know it's going to be a tough match no matter what. So, yeah, we're really happy with that.
And we saw some great service pressure there from Shauna and from her partner there. So quite hard to contend with in this win, Francesca.
Yeah, for sure. Definitely Key was really using that side. That is the sort of better side for the win. So we were really trying to concentrate on that first pass, because once that goes up and you're in system, then you can, you know, get some points. So, yeah, I was really happy with our composure. So it was good, yeah.
The composure was good. Well, you mentioned the wind. And Alice, how did you find the wind out there today at Ruakaka?
She's a bit gusty. I think everyone kind of battled with it a bit. It's definitely a factor. But yeah, we just kind of have to fight through it right now. Yeah.
Okay, well, we've already got the top New Zealand teams battling it out in the final. You're going forward to meet Julia Tilley and Olivia McDonald. Looking forward to that challenge, Francesca?
We are looking forward to it. We've been training with them all week, so I think we know each other really well, and it'll be a good battle. We've got a good strategy, so we're ready for it.
Alice, are you looking forward to the final?
Oh yeah. Like Francesca said, we're great training partners, so yeah, we know each other really well, so it'll be interesting.
Okay, well, this is the Northland Slam as part of the GJ Gardner Homes Tour, but it's also the New Zealand Championship. What would it mean to win that, Francesca?
I think for us, being a new pair, we're just focusing one game at a time. But if I do think about it, being New Zealand champ will be really cool. So to be honest with you, we would really like to win it, yeah.
Okay, and finally from you, Alice, you are one game at a time, but that game is the New Zealand Championships, and how would you feel if you could take home that title?
Yeah, it'd be pretty sweet. I reckon, yeah, we're just focusing on the process right now and just like working on us, so we'll see what happens.
Well, Alice Zaman and Francesca Kerwin, a brilliant win in the semi-final. They go through to the women's final to take on the top seeds, Olivia McDonald and Julia Tilley. It is going to be a barn burner here in the Northland Slam.
Thank you.
Barn burner, I don't know where that came from.
Love that. Good chat.